And welcome back. This is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, the White March, Blind. We are not doing this. Inside this cave is a huge dragon, which we, as far as I could ascertain anyway, we have no chance of defeating. So we're going to head back to town and wrap up a few quests. We've found a few things in the area, so yeah, we'll report back our findings and... Oh, I'm in sneak mode, duh. Great. For probably the third time, our south curtain wall construction is completed. Ravius is assigned, but it says assigned, and now it's gone. Yeah, we're in great here. Let's see. These things uncomplete themselves. So, now this one, again. Sooner or later I'll be done with this game and I can stop endlessly adding stuff that gets unadded. So we're supposed to see... Send tasks then. Okay, return Olmar's head to Teodor, which we have, and the thermal pearl is hatched, and we have a baby Logopath. He wanted us to find that too, so we have to see this Teodor guy. I believe he hangs out in front of or near the Grave's Rest, actually, it's that pronounced. Other than that, I'll have to check. I mean, I don't know of anything else. Maybe we can ask around about this sword that is cursed. There he is. He nods. Been keeping an eye on town here. You, found anything out near Longwatch for me? Well, first of all, the Gleaming Society is no more. Plenty of folk will be happy to hear it. Last thing we need is another big war. Take this. Gives you a bag of coin. Got 3,000 copper. And, this came out of the thermal pearl. The little creature sticks its head out of your pack and looks at Teodor with bulging blue eyes. His jaw flaps silently for a few seconds. I've never seen one so small. But the little fellow looks downright tame. He scratches his head. How about I buy it from you? The performers that pass through would take an interest in something like this. He bends down to look at the squirming Logopath. Adair yells, "Don't do it!" Do you have a reason for keeping it? What if I say no, I'm keeping him? Whatever you say, just watch your fingers when he gets big. I'm still looking for someone to take care of those dangerous folk roaming the area, if you're up to it. Yeah, I know, the sisters of the whatever. Sisterhood of the Slake Skull. Teodor offered to buy the Logopath, but I decided to keep it. It's a sign, Grieving Mother. I'm not sure what we have to gain by keeping it. But Adair wanted to keep it, so let's keep it, I guess. I guess I'm headed into the Durgan's battery now. Whirling agent made of copper, adra, and stone. Well, the only thing I could say is this steer seems to be pretty wise, so let's ask him about it. And I guess we'll ask Ren and Gil and see if we'll see if we can ask him about it. Might not even have the option. I don't know. It looks like from that... It looks like from the, what do you call it? The verse that we have to find a... an adra. An air adra or something? A wind adra? Elemental type thing?
Welcome. That is coming to your elders for advice, is it? What can I do for you?
Nope. Nearby, where I want to go anyway, where I came from. I want to go up to Durgan's battery next.
You've been busy since we last spoke. I want to thank you for what you've been doing.
Save it.
Something else you need?
Nope. Okay, we're out. We should probably rest.
Back to warm your hands, eh? What can I do for you? Top quality bear pelt.
Shit. Golden whale. Sleep. Adina Fergus, an old hero of the Saints Wars, arrived. Well, that's good.
Back to warm your hands, eh? What can I... Nothing like a...
That's not exactly what I want. Camping supplies. And lockpicks, why not? They went to stash, I hope. Just get rid of this crap. Done. Well rested. Plenty of camping supplies. Good to go. Wish us luck, guys.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Durgan's battery, here we come. 8 hours. According to Fiara, she lost her artifacts and her companions when she was attacked by Lagavath. When I find these creatures, I'll know her goods are nearby. Great. I'm already a little bit tired of fighting those things. Let's veer from the path. Take the road less traveled. Okay. I know it said Durgan's battery. I figured we'd just hit somewhere else in between. Can I just go? We're gonna go around, aren't we? Alright. There's a deer. Oh my god! What's this? Interesting. Looks like you fall right through that, like there's water underneath. Let's go see what's over here. A bitter spirit. Come on now, don't be so bitter. Oh, we've got to level up. I did not notice that. Oh, I didn't even mean to hit that. Hold on. I'm gonna fight it first. Yeah. Hold on, let me just get rid of this thing. Although I know it'll leveling up will help us fight it. He can't... Oh, he can't use his range... Oh, that stinks. That really stinks. I can't switch him out, I just realized that. So everyone else, attack this.
Following your lead.
You're the one I didn't command. Alright. Well, no, we don't have the problem of him not switching to the correct weapon. We just know he can't switch. I don't think we can knock him, but why not?
Let's go.
Some of us are petrified. Didn't look like it was attacking either. Why did this come up? I don't know why that came up. Okay, okay. Let's level people up. Let's get stuff first. Ooze plasma. 5 silver fittings.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea. Which is not very quiet.
Shit. Alright, athletics, I like. And survival. 6 survival. Stasis shell. The cipher is able to isolate a single enemy from the world, leaving them unable to act, but also unable to be affected by outside parties. Limited usefulness. Time parasite. By siphoning power from enemies' souls, the cipher is able to slow them down and increase his or her own speed. Oh, increase the cipher's speed. Alright. Well, that could be helpful. We don't have a lot of options, so... Aloth. Go with athletics. Delayed fireball. The wizard hurls out a tiny ball of flame that sits for a fixed amount of time before exploding for heavy burn damage. Okay. 61 through 79 burn. You know, it doesn't say what the fixed amount of time is. Okay. Lingrass warding staff. I can take two of these spells. The spell conjures a powerful quarterstaff that adds deflection and pushes enemies away with a hobbled effect on each successful attack. The summoning itself also pushes everyone, including allies, away from the caster. Oh, I like that very much. Ninagoth's Killing Bolt. 75 raw damage. Nice. This spell inflicts a heavy amount of raw damage to target. Any non-spirit felled by the attack will summon a specter under the caster's control. Really? So if with this spell, if we kill something that's not a spirit, I'll have a specter to control. I like that. Okay, so far that one. Substantial Phantom. Alas Duplicate. An advanced version of Essential Phantom, creating an independent copy of the wizard that can cast a small set of low-level spells. Due to the advanced nature of the spell, the copy from Substantial Phantom is more durable than Essential Phantom. That's cool. Tain's Chaotic Orb. Named for the eccentric Adirin wizard Tain, the Chaotic Orb bounces between a number of enemies, dealing damage and inflicting a variety of negative afflictions, including petrified, paralyzed, weakened, sickened, stunned, and blinded. Okay, so 24 to 37 crush. It's different durations, too. Petrified will be 4 seconds. Paralyzed for 5, weakened for 9, sickened for 10, stunned for 6.5, blinded for 8. And looks like the same for the jump targets. Plus 5. Oh, that's pretty cool. I like that. Wall of Draining. Enemies passing through or standing in this wall will lose time from any of their time beneficial status effects. For each second drain, the wizard gains duration on any beneficial status effects they have. That's pretty cool. Still 4 seconds duration from each beneficial attack. Alright, I'm going to take Tain's Chaotic Orb and Ninagoth's Killing Bolt. Done. Level 3 spells can now be used per encounter. Does that include Fireball? Was Fireball level 5?
Yes.
Oh, I can use... Wow. I can hurl... And the bounding missiles, and this fireball, I can use per encounter. That's awesome. Okay, Adair. Step up to the plate, big guy. Athletics. Fighter abilities. I might take critical defense. Plus 20% of incoming crits converted to hits. And plus 10% of incoming hits to grazes. So I won't be hurt as much. into the fray. Oh, that's neat. I think I'm going to take into the fray. Two per encounter, nice. Lunges into battle, pulling an enemy into immediate melee range, causing crush damage, leaving them dazed. Dazed is good. I'm going to take into the fray. We don't have a lot of these tactical stuff, so that'll make things interesting. Okay, Durance. More mechanics. Minor Avatar. Gains a supernatural glow as he or she is infused with power. The priest gains bonus on all attributes. Endurance, health, and weapon damage. Resurrect. Resurrection. Nice. Finally. The priest can resurrect. That will really help. Storm of Holy Fire. I've been waiting for him to get this spell. I figured he would never get it. Maybe just the paladin gets it. That's awesome. Storm of Holy Fire. Terrible rain of fire falls in the area of effect. We can get friendly fire with that, though. Level 3 spells can be used per encounter. Alright, so we'll have plenty of this. Restore moderate endurance. So we only have 3 spells. Those ones we saw. Alright. Does continuous burn damage. I like that too. I haven't been using these spells. Well, I should just go ahead and use them because we don't have any more healing. Alright, Pelagina. Can't increase athletics anymore, so how about survival? Inspiring Triumph. Plus 7 all defenses for 11.5 seconds. You have to down an enemy to get it. Liberating Exhortation. Hostile effects suspended. Zealous Charge. Sworn Enemy. Plus 15 accuracy against marked targets. I like that. So far we're going to go for Sworn Enemy. Deprive the Unworthy. Okay. Gets rid of or suspends beneficial effects. Commands an ally to redouble their efforts, improving deflection. Plus 25 deflection. Zealous Endurance. Hastening Exhortation. Attack speed buff. Healing Chain. Targets a single ally for healing. Oh, cut it out. The effect continues to jump between allies up to 6 times. It's pretty neat as well. Sacred Immolation. So the paladin takes a small amount of raw damage, Only six. The area of effect. Enemies take burn damage. Allies receive a small amount of endurance. Area of effect. Now is this per second or all together? Well, if it's per second, that's a lot of damage for her. And if it's not, well, this isn't significant. Let's take, what was it? Sworn enemy? Yeah. Done. And Kana. Athletics. They shielded their eyes against the vampire's gaze. Allies gain a bonus to their will defense and resist charm, confused, and dominated afflictions. Her courage, thick as steel, provides a barrier that soaks up damage against the Chanter's allies. That's pretty neat. Old Siak would not rest till his hunger was sated. Allies regain a portion of damage they inflict as endurance. I like that one. Now can I add this to the chants?
Following your lead.
I always forget how to do this. Edit, okay. Okay, so we have this, and then that. And what is it? Is it the foots? Yeah. Okay. All right. Good.
Sure.
Now we haven't explored that much, so I'm going to continue. Sure, this is going to be the calm before the storm, guys. Craig,
a stench. Even worse when dead. Gut him and bring him.
Hi. Greetings. Lately, the night winds send evil dreams to our matron. So we should stay together with us. Run along, little mouse. We go to the battery for cannons, but only when we must. Lately, the night winds. Matron Berrigan's visions guide us. Alright, that's it? I don't think the Winter Wolf's gonna talk, so I guess we'll continue.
I'll see what I can find.
Interesting. What we got here? Some random cavern. We'll be along our way then. We've killed so many of them before we found the matron. I guess they don't care about that. Help! Somebody help me! Who's calling out? The Rock? And I don't mean Dwayne Johnson or whatever his name is. Help! Please! I'm down here! Standing on a narrow outcropping far below the edge of the chasm, a villager waves his arms frantically. The villager is well out of reach, and the uneven, slick surface of the chasm would prove difficult to climb by hand. I'll go. Tie a rope around your waist and anchor it. Adair has a solid grasp of knots and steps forward to secure the line around your waist. The trapped man presses himself against the chasm wall. Please, hurry! The ice is starting to crack! I wonder if this is some kind of trick, though. Looking down, you can see another, smaller ledge further up along the side of the chasm. It is close enough to jump to, but it may not be able to support your weight. May not, climb down. You take firm hold of the rope and cautiously make your way down to the ledge. Oops! You hear an ominous crunch as the ice shifts somewhere below. The trapped man lets out an alarmed cry. Hurry! On the ledge, but we weren't going to that, you take a moment to survey your surroundings. Several sections of the cliffside below you appear to be comprised of thin sheets of ice, like windows set into the side of the chasm. The thin ice is pocked through with air bubbles, and moving too quickly across the surface could cause it to shatter. Rappel from the ledge is going quickly, right? Let's continue climbing down. You continue to carefully make your way down the cliffside. I don't think it'll hold much longer! You hear a faint clattering sound and a sharp cry. Glancing down, you see that the man has slipped, but he grabs hold of the rocky wall just in time to stabilize himself. Okay, I guess it's not all ice where he is, then. Oh, we don't have bulwark against the elements. As you pass the fragile section of ice, you feel the winds begin to pick up. The freezing gusts tug fiercely at your clothing, howling past you. Nearby, there's a narrow hollow in the wall of the cavern that could provide some shelter until the winds die down again. Is this guy gonna die if we hide in the gap for a sec? Let's hide in the gap. You take refuge in the hollow, giving your arms some much-needed rest in the process. Several long moments pass before the winds finally calm. In the lull that follows, you press onwards. Oops! You hear a sudden thud below and look down to see that the villager has lost his footing. He scrabbles desperately at the ice, but the entire ledge suddenly lurches and gives way. Oh, crap. You hear the man's screams long after he has plunged into the gloom below. After a few moments, a sickening crack echoes up the chasm. I guess I shouldn't have hid in that niche, then. You make your way back up the chasm and over the ledge to safety. Great. Great. Oh, well. What can you do? I didn't want to die and get thrown around by the winds. Alright, guys. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And when we explore more of Durgan's battery, endure, and enduring, grow strong.